the graceful swan. I stand in the doorway of the vast function hall and regard the delegates shuffling around, gossiping and plying themselves with obscene amounts of free alcohol. After quickly positioning myself in the center of the room, I find the largest group and start to engage. It's important not to let on that I'm the paid entertainment straight away. I simply ask polite questions, concerning finance in this case. Firmly in networking mode, everyone is acquiescent, happy to oblige. I check first that it'd be an open bar, an important measure, as people don't take kindly to paying for drinks and having them ruined. So, Reese, was it? I ask the corpulent man to my right. He nods, raising an eyebrow. Reese, there's something in your glass. Before he can reply, I clutch his half-full pint and release the first frog. 7 of the amphibians have been residing in my esophagus for the last 20 minutes. Sadly, a much healthier place for them, relatively speaking. Reese gasps and several people around him hoot and holler. I've revealed myself now and must shift into full entertainer mode. But it also means I can gladly free my remaining guests. Within 3 minutes, I've regurgitated all 7. The small crowd around me are receptive, responding with a perfect ratio of awe and disgust as their drinks are invaded. The most awkward part of the spectacle is retrieving the frogs a moment later. They'll make this as smooth as possible, accepting 2 at a time and depositing them into my small mobile tank backstage. Annoyingly, several delegates approach on my return and ask me to repeat the trick. I suppose their assumption that I can cough up frogs at will is a high form of praise. I deftly move on to a simple money trick, however, asking a woman to sign her own £20 note, apparently setting it alight before her eyes, before handing it back, fully intact, signature and all. This is all sleight of hand. I'd of course switched it with my decoy note halfway through. My now vacant esophagus allows me to perform a different kind of swallowing spectacle. I make it seem like I've retrieved a 6 of clubs from my stomach with a 3-foot table centerpiece, when in fact the card was attached afterwards in a swift, imperceptible movement. As expected, my audience laps this up. The combination of swallowing, which is all technique and very much real, with expert card manipulation, never fails to impress. You see someone swallowing a sword at the circus and you surmise that he's just highly trained. You see someone performing with cards and you know it's simply a trick. You see a man doing all 3 simultaneously and you're baffled completely. It's not only taken thousands of hours of practice to get to this moment. The moment itself is full of stress, fast decision making in real time. I'm the graceful swan gliding across the lake. My audience has no notion of the chaotic paddling, the hideous struggle occurring beneath the surface. By this point, I've attracted a substantial proportion of the guests, and it's time to up my game. I perform several impressive feats to universal approval. Handcuff tricks, memory games, the removal of jewellery. It's all going swimmingly until the booker, Veronica, trundles over, large grin plastered across her face.
Bravo, Warren! You're going down so much better than the comedians we usually hire.
Oh, thank you.
Actually, one of the chaps on the receiving end of your frog trick happened to be our CEO.
I smile. Sorry.
No, he loved it. But he does have a slightly odd request.
Ask away.
So he was gifted these 2 ornamental swords earlier.
She pauses.
Perhaps you could swallow one, and we'll post a photo to our Instagram page.
She hands me a sword and I immediately feel the weight of it. Although the ones I use are just as solid, I take the rather sensible precaution of blunting them.
He did say he'd increase your fee,
she blurts.
Does an extra 15% sound good?
I feign a smile. Extra money and free promotion? There's no way I can refuse. keenly aware of the blade's sharpness, I insert it with the utmost care. And when I drop down to one knee, the balding CEO poses over me, gripping the hilt like some kind of surreal King Arthur, which I suppose makes me the stone. "You're a great sport," he says softly as I'm retrieving it. "How about you indulge me one last time, and I'll bump up your fee by another 10%. Christ, what now? When the CEO tells me his request, I stifle the urge to roll my eyes. Can't these idiots understand that I have safety measures to follow? But the promise of even more cash has lured me in, and sadly I oblige him. For the next tawdry photo opportunity, I swallow both swords at once, slowly and cautiously, before kneeling between the CEO and the financial director. The men grip each hilt. The picture is taken. I carefully stand up. But the angle feels decidedly different as I start the retrieval process. Something awful has happened. Scissored is the technical term. One sword has deviated from the safe path, and by the time I'm pulling it out, I literally feel the slice of internal tissue. The pain is excruciating. I do incredibly well to hide it. After loudly announcing my name and social media handles, telling Veronica that I'll email her the invoice when I get back, I slump into my hatchback and cough into a handkerchief, inspecting it and immediately noting a decent amount of blood. Despite all this, I somehow manage the 10-minute drive to A&E, grunting with pain upon every change of gear. When I climb out of the car, I feel a vicious jolt of pain from somewhere in my torso. 3 pitiful steps later, I collapse onto the concrete. Before I lose consciousness, I'm comforted by the notion of being alone in this moment, totally unseen. I remained the graceful swan. This hideous struggle will die with me.
Thanks for making it all the way to the end of the video. If you enjoyed it, please like it and share it around. And if you're feeling especially generous, hit the subscribe button.